thank God and welcome back to the Full Bible Study program as we continue John chapter 18. My friend, I hope that you've put on the full armor of God because there's a battle going on, not only against principalities and powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, but it would seem like it's against flesh and blood because they've come to arrest Jesus. He's been handed over by one of his own, a disciple who walked with him for the past 3 years. So they called over Jesus, and as their eyes searched among the disciples, they knew they had him this time. With Judas on their side, how could they fail? But the Bible says, as soon as Jesus said unto them, I am he, they went backward and fell to the ground. Beloved, is that a familiar scene? Well, join us next time as we talk about it. In Jesus' name, amen. Praise God, and welcome back to the Full Bible Study program as we continue John chapter 18. Beloved, we thank God for Jesus Christ. We thank him for the effort that he has taken, the courage to stand up to his adversaries. Had it been me, I would have ran off like a jackrabbit, like much of the other disciples did. At first, the scene was that of a bloodthirsty ruse and that man Jesus type of mob. But no sooner had Jesus spoken, they turned into a cemetery where every man was flat on his back. For a brief moment, they came into the actual presence of the Almighty, Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus the Christ, the Anointed One, the Lamb of God that taken away the sin of the world, the same one to whom angels had just ministered, the same one who moments before declared that he will drink the cup of suffering and death because it was the Father's will. The Bible says that every knee shall bend. These criminals resisted, and sure enough, they came up against the divine wall, which is Jesus Christ. But I'm not through yet. Join me again. In Jesus' name, amen. Praise God and welcome back. Beloved, let's move on to verse 7 of John chapter 18. Now the war has started and there is no turning back. But let me warn you, if for any reason you feel sorrow in your spirit or a measure of fear, remember what the word says. 2 Timothy 1:7, for God hath not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. So shake that fear off. Jesus said prophetically in John 16:33, be of good cheer, I have overcome the world. Beloved, what more do you need? Now, verse 7, Jesus said, whom seek ye? And they said, Jesus of Nazareth. My friend, the statement tells us that there may have been many Jesuses around, but only one from Nazareth, born in a little town called Bethlehem. Verse 8 says, if you want me, take me, but don't touch my man. Beloved, listen to this. The window of salvation was open right there, even before the cross. Remember that. See you next time. Praise God and welcome back as we continue John chapter 18. Beloved, may I just mention right here that Jesus has fulfilled the prophecies that pertain to his birth, his ministry, his death, and the resurrection. They are yet more to be fulfilled, and those pertain to his second coming. But according to the Jews, he did not meet the requirements of the long-awaited Messiah. My friend, there are some of us who must witness history unfold itself before we can believe. How true is the statement which the Bible says, prophesying is for them which believe. 1 Corinthians 14:22. Now in John 17:12, Jesus prophesied while praying to the Father, and he said none of his disciples were lost except for Judas, the son of perdition. And so the confrontation came to an end, and they arrested Jesus and took him away. But it did not go down that easy. Marcus lost his right ear when Peter drew his sword, probably attempting to cut him down in half, and missed and cut his ear off. There is more, but join me again. Amen. Praise God, and welcome back to the Full Bible Study program. Beloved, we are currently studying John chapter 18, and for your information, there's a battle going on in the garden. One man has lost his ear, another is about to be arrested on charges of blasphemy, accused of being a malefactor calling himself the Son of God. Oh, they were killing their Savior in the name of the Lord. How blind they were. Now, this garden is the place that none of us should forget because it was in the garden that the first Adam was overthrown through disobedience. And so God made it that it would be in the garden that man would become reconnected to God through the obedience of Jesus Christ. Jesus did agree, not my will, but thy will be done. Luke 22:42. Beloved, first time caller, hear me. You can become a child of God simply by accepting Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. I plead on your behalf, hear me. You've got to turn and come back to the Father. He's waiting for you. See you next time.